If you have a PC problem and need help from someone else, you can use Quick Assist to have them connect to your computer remotely over the internet so they can fix it on your behalf. To see how it works, we'll begin by switching to our friend's PC, who will be helping out remotely. First, they'll need to start Quick Assist by searching for it from the taskbar, then selecting it from the results to open up. Next, they'll need to select the second option to give assistance to someone else remotely, then sign in with their Microsoft account if prompted. This'll create a 6-digit security code that they'll need to give to you in order to connect. They can either provide it to you over the phone, copy it to the clipboard so they can paste it into a chat message, or send it by email. Quick Assist also provides handy instructions on how to use it, which they can pass on to anyone else they help out in the future. Note that the security code will expire in 10 minutes, so make sure you both connect before then. Otherwise, you'll need to generate a new code. Let's now switch back to your PC to continue. Once you've received the code from your friend, start Quick Assist by searching for it like before, then selecting it from the results. Next, choose the first option to get assistance from someone you trust, then enter the security code they provided and click Submit, which will take up to a minute or so to connect. When it's ready, click Allow to confirm that you give permission for the other person to access and control your PC remotely, after which you'll both be connected. You can then use the Quick Assist toolbar at the top of your screen to pause the screen sharing anytime, as well as disconnect completely when you're done. Let's jump back again to your friend's PC. Once the connection's made, they'll be able to view and control your PC remotely. By default, Quick Assist will resize the remote display to fit their screen, although they can use the toolbar above to view the actual size to make things clearer. Then, use the scroll bars below and on the right to navigate the screen. They can also use the toolbar to add annotations directly to your screen by selecting a pen and an optional color from the left, then dragging the mouse to write or draw on it. To remove the annotations, click the eraser icon at the top, then click Exit on the far right to close. Other things they can do from the toolbar include restarting your PC and loading Task Manager, which we've explored in a separate video. And of course, since they have control of your PC's keyboard and mouse, they can go ahead and troubleshoot the problem for you while you sit back and watch. And we're back in good shape. Once your friends resolve the issue for you, they can end the screen sharing by clicking the stop button on the top right of the toolbar, after which they can reconnect again if they forget something, or just close the app to finish up. Alternatively, to end the screen sharing from your end, just close the Quick Assist toolbar, then click the Close button again to confirm, followed by the Quick Assist app window. So, next time you have a computer problem, don't waste time on the phone explaining it to a friend. Use Quick Assist so they can resolve it for you.